Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Astha Dayal. And I'm a consultant in gynecology in CK Birla Hospital in Gurgaon. And as we all know, the first week of August is celebrated as the World Breastfeeding Week. And this year in 2020, the theme is to support breastfeeding for a healthier planet. So we thought we'll have a discussion about the benefits of breastfeeding, the problems people face, and how to resolve them. So let me start off by saying that as all of you know, breastfeeding or breast milk is the best gift a mother can give to her child. It teaches the child the first life skill, which is to suckle and to feed, and it has a lot of benefits both for the baby and the mother. So it actually gives the best nutrition to the baby, jo hum sabko pata hi hai that it is full of the proper amount of water, of fat, of carbohydrates and of proteins and minerals which it gives to the baby, and the nutritional component actually keeps changing as the baby grows. So it modifies itself according to the baby's requirement, and it also, besides this, it gives a lot of immunity to the baby. तो जो भी द मदर्स इम्यूनिटी दैट शी इज गेन्ड इन दीज ईयर्स ऑफ हर लाइफ शी कैन गिव इट टू हर न्यू बेबी बाय द ब्रेस्ट मिल्क सो ऑल द एंटीबॉडीज द हॉर्मोन्स द सेल्युलर इम्यूनिटी इज गिवन टू द बेबी थ्रू द ब्रेस्ट मिल्क बाय द मदर एंड ऑल दीज हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एडवांटेजेस टू द बेबी बिकॉज इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द बेबी फ्रॉम अ लॉट ऑफ डिजीजेस स्पेशली एलर्जिक डिजीजेस लाइक एस्थमा like skin allergies, eczemas, it's easier to digest and it causes lesser, so babies who are breastfed have lesser problems in their digestive system, they have lesser chances of having stomach infections, they are less prone to having respiratory infections, which are very common nowadays in the younger children. And it also eventually later on in life, it helps in controlling childhood obesity, in type 2 diabetes mellitus. So these are the lifestyle diseases which now are becoming very prevalent. So breastfeeding actually protects your child from these as well. And it also benefits the mother. It helps you bond with the baby. It helps you in your weight loss, which is a very big thing for all mothers, because after their delivery they want to lose their weight faster. And besides this, it also, like long-term breastfeeding has been shown to reduce your chances of breast cancer and ovarian cancer. Breastfeeding is having a lot of advantages, but it is also an effort. It is an effort when both you and your baby are learning to feed and you're learning to cope up with it. And it has some problems which can be easily overcome. So you should always try and breastfeed, and generally we advise you that your baby can start feeding within the first hour of birth if it is an uncomplicated pregnancy. So pehle hi kuch ghanton mein, for all uncomplicated pregnancy, we immediately do a skin to skin to the baby of the baby and mother after birth. And even in a cesarean, we do a skin to skin and we initiate breastfeeding as soon as possible. And you should breastfeed for about 6 months exclusively. So the baby should, for the baby, the breast milk is enough. They don't need any extra nutrition, not even water, for the first 6 months. And after 6 months, when you introduce other feeds, then also you can continue breastfeeding for up to a year or even longer if you feel like. Now, I do feel that there are a lot of initial teething problems that you have with breastfeeding. And it is important to understand and to learn it, and you can learn the best when you have the baby in your arms. So I tell my patients that whenever you come for delivery, you're here in the hospital for about 3 days or so, and the first day of course you're delivering, but then uske baad there are 2 days when you're recovering, so you should really try and learn breastfeeding at that time. We have lactation consultants, we have a lot of the doctors and nurses. They all explain the technique to you, they all support you, they all help you. So you should really focus on learning how to breastfeed in these 2 days. Now, breastfeeding mein thore thore jo common factor, jo common cheeze hoti hain, that I'd like to tell you. सबसे पहले कि द फर्स्ट टू डेज यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग अ लिटिल येलोइश थिकिश डिस्चार्ज विच इज कॉल्ड द कोलोस्ट्रम विच पीपल ऑल्सो से इज द फर्स्ट गोल्डन लिक्विड दैट यू कैन गिव टू योर चाइल्ड. Why? Because this colostrum is very rich in the things which give immunity to your baby. So that is what you have to start feeding your baby. And it is a smaller quantity of colostrum which comes. So sometimes mothers feel that, is that enough for my baby? But when the baby is just born, the baby's stomach is really small. So colostrum itself suffices. And then the third day onward, the whitish milk starts coming, which is a little thinner in consistency. And as the baby grows, the milk becomes more in quantity and in quality. It keeps changing. Now, the common questions are that how often do you feed your baby? So every baby who is breastfed should generally feed in about 2 to 3 hours in a day. And then, so generally once you feed, you should feed for around 15 to 20 minutes. From one breast. We generally advise that you feed from one breast and then you go on to the other breast and then you feed from both the sides at one go. Some women feed alternately, which is also okay if your baby is satisfied with one breast. And how do you know that your baby is full? That means that the baby will be comfortable for the next 2 hours or 3 hours. And initially in the first week of birth, the babies have a weight loss of about 10%. And after that, they regain their birth weight in the 10th to 14th day of life. And then they continually start gaining weight. So if your weight gain of the baby is adequate, if the baby is passing urine which is not very dark in color, if the baby is pooping 3 to 6 times in a day, and the baby is comfortable and playful, then that means that the baby is not hungry and the baby is getting enough nutrition from your breast milk. But you have to understand that breastfeeding is comfortable when both you and your baby are comfortable in that position, because you have to breastfeed for a long duration. In the 24 hours, maybe you're feeding for about 18 hours in the day. So you have to be comfortable in that position. So I tell all my patients that whenever you're breastfeeding, the basic factors you should keep in mind is that you should not bend on the baby, and your body parts should be very well supported. You should have a backrest. You should have a nursing pillows or some support below your arms where you're holding the baby. So you should be in a very comfortable position, and you have to bring the baby close to your breast and not the breast close to the baby. And when you're feeding the baby, you have to make sure that the baby is not just nibbling on the nipples. The baby has to, the baby's mouth should be full of the breast, and the outer part, which is the areola, should also be a little bit in the baby's mouth. So when the baby is suckling, at that time you should not feel any pain, and that is how you know that your position of suckling is comfortable. Now a lot of mothers feel that their nipples hurt, so and then it becomes sore. So what you can do about it is you have to keep your nipples moisturized. You have to generally sometimes give some lanolin or some moisturizers. But if you're not cleaning it with soap too often, then the natural fluids are not washed away, and you can apply the milk also over it, or some people even apply ghee over it. So if you keep the nipples moisturized, it is generally, it heals whenever if there's any soreness of the breast. And some people who have flat nipples, they should generally, we show them how to express the nipple out while feeding with a syringe, or sometimes you can even use a nipple shield to help you feed. Now a lot of mothers feel that sometimes pumping out or expressing breast milk and giving their child is more comfortable as an option, and they do ask me that, can't I do this all the time? So the answer is yes, it is comfortable, and yes, the good part is that you are giving the breast milk to your baby. But you also need to understand that if you're only making the baby have the expressed milk, then the baby starts suckling, starts understanding that that is very easy to get and without any effort, and then the baby stops making an effort in breastfeeding, which is good for the baby also. So you should always suckle, and the more the baby suckles and empties the breast, the more milk production happens. So you should still always attempt to suckle on the breast, and if the baby is still hungry, then maybe you can give the expressed breast milk to the baby. Now, what are the factors with which your milk production gets affected? So most mothers make enough milk for their baby, and I feel that I think a very big factor which I have noticed in my practice is how stressful the whole situation is for the mother. Now, generally we tell you that you should have to have a good production of breast milk. You should have adequate nutrition. You should have enough, like around 500 extra calories you need for your energy, which like in pregnancy you need 350 extra calories, but you need more nutrition while breastfeeding. So you need to supplement that. You need to have enough calcium, vitamin D. So you should supplement your diet well, and very importantly, you should have a lot of fluids. So you should have about 3 liters extra liquids so that your breast milk is coming in adequate quantity. Now, there are a lot of traditions and a lot of things which, like for new mothers, have to, sometimes they're not given enough nutrition so that their tummy doesn't trouble them. Especially if they have a cesarean section, some people don't eat anything for a week or so. So that generally will affect your breast milk. So you should have adequate nutrition, you should have adequate fluid intake, and you should not be stressed, which is the most important thing. So we have seen that patients who have a very uncomplicated pregnancy, who are always positive about it, who are comfortable breastfeeding, and they generally don't have any issues with it. Also, like the second time mothers, they generally are very happy breastfeeding because they've done it the first time. They know the teething problems, they know that it eventually settles, they're not very stressed about it, they're a little more confident, so they obviously do a better job at breastfeeding. So your stress levels really affect your breastfeeding. Sometimes if your pregnancy is very complicated, if it's a very difficult delivery, or if after a surgery, and if there are very high levels of stress, then it can pose a few problems in breastfeeding. It can pose a few problems in bonding with your baby as well. And this I've noticed lately in this coronavirus pandemic, where I feel a lot of us are facing a lot of feelings of isolation, feelings of insecurity, you sometimes can't bring your parents or your in-laws, so there are no elders at home to guide you, and you also feel a little scared about how to breastfeed, how to take care of a newborn. So these things sometimes do pose a problem, because if you don't have enough support for breastfeeding, you generally tend to give it up because you feel that the easy way out would be to just give an express feed or just to give like a formula feed. But I would say that be confident and be positive and don't just give up on it. So basically you have to try your best. There are a lot of foods also which help, which I think in Indian households we generally do give. And there are Ayurvedic preparations, there are some medicines also which improve your breast milk. And all these things do help to a certain extent. And of course, if you are feeling positive about it, if you're very well motivated for breastfeeding, it does happen. But there are a few cases where sometimes it doesn't happen. Even if we try everything, we try our best, but nothing's working, then also I would say that you should not really feel very dejected or feel that there's something wrong with you or anything, or you're depriving your child of anything. You should still give whatever is coming, and you can supplement it with your formula feed, because nutrition wise formula feed is as good. It is just that maybe if you breastfeed, then you give a little immunoglobulins, a little more of immunoglobulins, and it helps with the bonding with the baby. So you should not give it up so soon. But if you've tried everything and it doesn't work, then it's okay, just chill. So, but still, whatever supplement you can do with your breast milk, you should continue with that. Another thing I would like to say in today's scenario, because we are delivering patients who have in this coronavirus pandemic, so a good thing that we're doing is we're checking all the pregnant women before delivery, whether they're positive or they're negative for coronavirus. So if you're negative, it's very good. Everything is like normal and everything is safe. But a good and a relieving factor to know is that if, God forbid, if a pregnant woman has a coronavirus positive, then she is generally not more severely affected. and very, very few, in fact, just maybe 3 or 4 cases of mother-to-child transmission have been seen. And it has not been shown to be transmitted through breast milk. So if you are positive, you can still feed your mother, feed your baby with your breast milk. But you just have to take a few precautions. You have to, you can either express the milk and then give it to somebody who is not positive and that person can feed the baby. Or if you are wanting to feed yourself, then you should wear a mask, you should wear gloves, and you should basically keep the feeding time to limited, and then also you can breastfeed your baby. And God forbid, even if the baby becomes corona positive, the babies generally take it very well. There is just a mild illness and most of the babies are asymptomatic. So we don't have to worry about it also too much. I think that I'd like to stress is that sometimes that when you go home after your delivery and you're feeding your baby, sometimes even like as traditionally we don't allow our mothers to step out too often, and now because of coronavirus you're all the more wary of coming to the hospital. But you have to take care that if your breast starts becoming red, or if you feel that it is tender on touching, or if you feel that there is any fever, or the breastfeeding is becoming very painful, these could be signs of mastitis. So you should not be ignoring them, and you should check with your doctor as soon as possible, whether on a video consult or otherwise, because you will be needing some medication, some antibiotics probably. And you should, to prevent this, you should be careful that whenever your breast starts becoming very full, you should either feed the baby or you should express it and preserve it. And you should also have a very good supportive bra. And you can also do a cold compress. So if the breast is becoming too full. I hope I answered all your basic queries about breastfeeding. And I really hope all our new mothers are well motivated for breastfeeding, knowing the advantages of it, and are not stressed about it, are very confident about it, and realize that it is a very good gift to give to your little babies. And I hope all of you have a very healthy and happy pregnancy. So I would end the session now. Thank you so much.